Roll for Crit presents How to Play Big Trouble in Little China, the game, in 5 minutes or less or more. Big Trouble in Little China is the cooperative strategy game based on the movie of the same title, in which you get to fight off the evil Lo Pan and actually do what old Jack Burton does. Designed by Boris Polonsky, Chris Patarlis, and Jim Sammartino, and published by Everything Epic Games. Your goal in Big Trouble is to defeat the evil sorcerer David Lo Pan before time runs out. Each player will begin with a hero, their hero board, 3 action dice, upgrade cards, and a special ability card, and some level up tokens and quest tokens. You get to choose which side of your special ability card you'll use for the game, as well as 1 upgrade card to start with on its non-epic side. If playing with fewer than 4 players, you'll also get helpful companion cards, and you may start with different amounts of chi, which is like experience points, or audacity, according to the audacity track at the top of the board. The game is separated into 2 distinct acts, designated by 2 different sides of the board. In Act 1, your goal is to move the Audacity token along its track until it hits this center section. Meanwhile, the Big Trouble track represents evil and will also be moving forward as you play. If either track token reaches the center spot, then Act 1 immediately ends and Act 2 begins, but you want the Audacity track to get there first, ideally. All heroes begin the game in space number 1 of the Dragon of the Black Pool restaurant. The board is separated into numbered spaces and walled off zones. Each round of the game has 2 phases, the hero phase and the enemy phase. The first thing you'll always do is flip the top card of the Big Trouble deck and follow its instructions. The number in the top left tells you how far to advance the Big Trouble track that round. Then, there may also be a special effect and the spawn section, telling you what enemies to spawn according to the number of players and difficulty level you're using. Keep in mind that on the very first round of the game, you'll only spawn enemies and ignore the rest of the card. Now, place those enemies on the board in the space indicated, and the heroes can then start taking their turns. Players decide who they want to go first each round, then play continues clockwise until everyone is finished. On your turn, you'll roll all of your available action dice. You can then take multiple actions depending on how you decide to allocate your action dice onto your hero board. There are 3 symbols on the action dice: body, mind, and spirit. To perform an action, you'll take 1 or more dice of any symbol and place them into the appropriate track or tracks on your board. It doesn't matter which symbols you apply to any given action as long as you place them in the right tracks. You can mix and match or keep it to just 1 type. You can use each die for a separate action or put them all in together for 1 larger action, as each die spent makes your action more powerful. You'll also notice that certain sections of your dice tracks have colorful borders around them, which means that they are epic slots. A die placed in an epic slot gives you an even stronger version of a typical action. Now, let's explain all the actions. Move. You can move up to 2 spaces for each die allocated for this action, into adjacent spaces only, and not through walls. But these red lines indicating doorways are fair game. There are also special gateways such as manholes that can instantly take you to their matching counterpart space elsewhere on the board. If moving out of a space with enemies in it, you take 1 damage for each enemy present. Epic moves let you travel up to 3 spaces instead of just 2. Combat. If you are in the same space as an enemy or have a ranged attack and have line of sight with no walls or red lines between you, you can perform a combat check. For each die you allocate to combat on your board, you receive 1 white skill die or 1 yellow skill die for dice in epic slots. Roll your skill dice and add up the total number. If it's equal to or higher than your enemy's health, you defeat them and they are removed from the board, and you get a reward. If not, you'll trigger their strike back ability, which usually results in doing damage to your hero, which you can track on your hero board. Demon heads on skill dice are misses, and you lose 3 health if you ever roll 3 of them at once. Skill check. Certain quests throughout the game will require you to perform skill checks of varying difficulties. For each die you allocate to a skill check, you receive 1 skill die or 1 yellow skill die, just like combat. Roll those dice, then check your number against the skill check number. If it's equal or higher, you passed. Otherwise, you failed. What happens as a result of this outcome will vary depending on what the skill check was for, which you'll find out by reading a card or the quest book. If you trigger a skill check on your turn, you must immediately attempt it with at least 1 die. Tasks. Certain quests or events will require players to complete tasks. They will show you a series of symbols corresponding to the dice tracks on your hero board. For each die you place of the matching symbol, you place a pass marker on the related space. A die in an epic slot can stand in for any symbol required. Once all spaces are covered, the task is complete. Any player can contribute to a task if they are in the appropriate space on their turn and there are no enemies in the space with them. Task actions with a merged box mean that you must commit all the required dice in the same turn. Rest. Resting refills your health by 2 or 3 with an epic slot. If your health is already full, you get a chi instead. There are also some actions you can take on your turn for free, meaning without using any action dice. You can open a crate in your space, which could be an item or an enemy. You can use an item that you've received from a crate or from a shop space on the board. You can trade items with heroes in the same space as you, or you can trigger quest tokens on the board. You'll find both main quests and side quests in various locations on the board. Main quests can only be triggered by the appropriate hero, while side quests can be triggered by anyone. A side quest will relate to a side quest card, which give you further instructions as to how to complete it, while a main quest will point you to a section of the quest book. In the quest book, you'll find some flavor text, may need to make a choice, then complete a skill check or combat challenge before being able to move on to the next step. Once triggered, any hero can participate in a main quest. Each quest is different and will present you with unique challenges and rewards, so read up. Various spots on the board also have actions you can take there, such as the aforementioned shops, at which you can spend one die to take one of the items present there. Items have various effects, such as healing you or causing damage to enemies. Once all players have finished using all of their dice, it's time for the enemy phase. First, each enemy on the board moves up to their printed speed towards the closest hero. Then they attack the closest hero, doing damage equal to their printed attack value. Heroes may be able to block this damage by rolling the appropriate defense dice printed on their hero board. For each number rolled, they block 1 point of damage. If there is a tie for closest player when deciding where enemies should move or who they should attack, it is broken by whoever has the highest chi. In addition to typical enemies known as minions, there are also bosses who work in the same way but have stronger abilities and take multiple hits to defeat. Minions are unable to move through red lines, while bosses can do whatever they want. Once all enemies have moved and attacked if able, the round ends and a new one begins. Throughout the game, your heroes will be receiving chi from defeating enemies, moving up the audacity tracks, or completing quests. You start the game with 0 chi. Each time you hit 10 chi on your board, you reset it to 0 and level up. To level up, take the next sequential level token and place it on your board. You then get to choose an upgrade listed on the token, either gaining a new upgrade card, flipping an existing upgrade card to its epic side, or possibly gaining an additional action die. You also have your health track. If your health track reaches 0, you reset it to 10, advance the big trouble track by 1, and take a hell card, which has very bad effects, so you don't want to do this. Otherwise, hitting 0 health does not affect you or your turn in any way. You also need to be aware of the fate dice, special dice you can use if you're desperate for some extra help on your turn. These dice are rolled at the beginning of the game, and each symbol provides a special bonus. You can take one of these dice on your turn to add to a roll or use for its ability. At the end of that turn, you'll roll that die. If you receive one of the negative symbols printed on the fate track, you must carry out the punishment listed next to the fate track slot number you're currently on, then place that die in the next empty slot on the track. Once the track is full, re-roll the 6 fate dice. As soon as one of the 2 tracks at the top of the board reaches the center, Act 2 begins. You'll now flip the board over and create a new setup according to a series of showdown quest cards matching the quests you had available in Act 1. Depending on whether or not you've completed those quests, Act 2's setup will change, so read the cards. Act 2's basic gameplay is the same as Act 1's, except that the central arena area of the board will be locked until you can gain enough keys by completing a certain number of showdown quests, depending on the number of players. Once you're able to get into the arena, you can start to fight Lopan. Lopan works like any other boss enemy, but of course with his own unique abilities. Once you've defeated him, he'll turn from his ghost form into his human form and move to the top floor. Defeat him again in this form, and you've won the game. Act 2 also features a new Big Trouble track, which moves down instead of up. In Act 2, you'll no longer receive new Big Trouble cards. Each round, this track will simply move down one space, and if it reaches the end before you defeat Lopan, you lose. The track also moves down anytime one of your heroes hits 0 health. In conclusion, move, fight, quest, it's all in the reflexes. That's Big Trouble in Little China the game in a nutshell. Did you get all that?